Oh, hey. Didn't see you there. Welcome to Cooking Under Quarantine with your quarantine contestant, Spencer. Today, we're going to start out with our cocktail, Doomsday, which is going to be the toilet paper airplane, thanks to everyone's true desire for what their butthole needs. So we've got our ingredients up here in equal proportions, which are going to be set up to give us maximum flavor, I think. So a little bit of a twist on the classic with the addition of coconut milk here, but the kind of idea of the program is, being quarantined, we are not going to add any new ingredients here. Shoot every day and decide exactly what we're going to make every day with a little bit of apocalypse theme. So everything goes into equal parts here. I'm making a double, so about an ounce and a half of every ingredient is going into this. First thing is we've got bottled in bond bourbon. Then we're going with some Aperol. And it is going to have a pretty interesting color, I think. I'm going to be excited to see how this one turns out. Now we've got a couple more segments on here for you. Decided to do it very raw, you know, just nasty kitchen. Everything you've ever wanted to see in the kitchen, just to show you that we're there for you during these tough times. Everybody's got to make sacrifices, and our production budget is really what's taking the biggest hit here. So just real raw, real people eating real food, which is the only thing we have in the fridge. So we're taking our measly fridge offerings. You know, I wanted to really kind of shake it up, and that's about what we're gonna do here. Get this all shook up, home. And once we get this lemon juice in here, we are ready to shake and bake. This is gonna make a real pleasurable sound experience for you. So this is our little cocktail hour to midnight, and our Doomsday clock. Paper airplane's been a great cocktail, but the toilet paper airplane has that coconut bottle in it, which I think is going to add a gross flavor. But who knows? Let's find out. We've got our two fancy glasses here. Clearly the same size. Oh, yeah. Well, you know, this toilet paper is more of a natural toilet paper. I tried to add a white thing to bleach it, but there's too much red going on in there to really keep that down. Just like the desire to be socialist, that kind of red is too much to keep down. All right, let's do this. Do a quick taste of this here. Through a little bit, you know, just muddles what is otherwise a fantastic cocktail. But I'll still drink it because it's the apocalypse and it's all good. So next up, I'm going to start our main course today, which is going to be a pita. Here we have our mise en place with our pitas. And this is going to involve us making a little bit of a nice, how do you want to say, marinade for our chicken. And we have our nasty little bit of chicken. This is the only chicken we got left here in the apocalypse, last chicken. So we thank this chicken for its sacrifice and everything that it did. Some scissors here. Chop her up. Was just the chicken spine breaking. Nothing to worry about. And I'm just going to toss it in here. And I'm going to toss in our bootleg marinade. Which is going to be, oh, beautiful. Great shot. Love that. That's real cooking for you. But guess what we're going to do is we're going to wash that off. Oh, yeah, chicken hand. So amazing. COVID-19 hand washing techniques. Get a lot of water. Love that stuff. It's real great. Squirt a little bit of that on there. And they say you gotta wait for a full 20 minutes. I believe that's where I read it. Just gonna scrubby dub, little bub, before we dump all of our nice and saucy ingredients in there. Actually, first, what I'm gonna do is a little scissoring action. You know, who doesn't love a good bit of scissoring? I'm gonna chunk it up nice. So, this is going to allow us to increase the surface area, which is gonna really make this get nice and perfect with all the marinade we're gonna put in here. Alright, so we've got our chicken kind of diced here, nice and cubular, and we are going to introduce our little bit of marinade here. So this is going to help soften the chicken, put it in for about 20 minutes I guess, put some lemon juice, and then put in some of this milk. This is the only milk we got. I hope it's good. If it's not, guess what? We've got a yogurt sauce. Cool. Tasty. And put in there. Just gonna get this nice and moist. After this, we're going to... Let me just space this out with a little bit of a taste of my doomsday clocktail. Cocktail is very good. Very interesting. Love that. Needs a lot. So I've got this Syrian spice mix that I'm just going to dump a lot of this in here. This is going to help pull out some of the flavor from the chicken. And it's going to come out real nice when we roast it in about 20 minutes. I'm just going to do a nice. Oh, cool. Got a hole.
Love that. Love that in a Ziploc.
But the beauty about Ziploc bags is there is not a run on those in the store, so we're just going to double bag this. Screw a little bread here. We're going to be making some everything bagel bread. Got a little pack of dried yeast here. We're going to get some warm water, get it about body temperature, and then dope it with some sugar and put our little yeasties in here. The wee beastie yeasties so they can feed. Alright. We might be out of warm water. This is a true crisis in America. Oh, no. We're getting up the temperature here. Getting a little bit hot. Let's do a little review of the cocktail ingredients. We've got our bourbon, our Aperol, our Amaro Nonino, coconut water, avoid this if you can, and just lemon juice from concentrate. Real lemons, great, love them. Well, it would have been much better. We don't have access to that here. Well, this is cooking in quarantine. So, all right. Got a little thing of hot water here. Let's put our wee yeasties into our cup here. And I'm gonna kind of wait for this to get nice and good and foamy. And that's gonna be our tell for when we're gonna be able to add it to our, basically our flour and egg and oil mixture. It's gonna be pretty darn delicious. You see, we still got our meat marinated here. And for sort of our appetizer, also the filling for our pita pockets of destruction. We are going to make a little bit of a salad. For that, we've got pickles, mayonnaise, salad. Cool. Oh, and our dear friend Onion. Almost forgot about this guy. Love this guy. Brings a tear to your eye. Real great jokes. So now we're going to chop this bad boy in half because, like I said, we're not adding any more ingredients here. We got two onions. So I'm going to save half of this onion for something else later on in this quarantine experience. And one half of this onion, I think I'm going to do about a quarter in the salad and then add a quarter of this to our chicken during cooking. Give us a nice little flavor boost. So, we've only got a couple pickles left here. We're going to save this pickle juice because, let me tell you, during the apocalypse, you just can't throw everything away. Especially not something as good as pickle juice. And that was a lot more pickle juice than I would have expected. But here what we're going to do is start out throwing a bunch of these pickles into our little salad bowl here with a quarter of it. And you can see the little yeasty friends are going to work here. Fill me up nice and good. Our starter is moving. We're going to toss that in once they've given them some good time to make a lot of yeasty love. Love in the time of yeast cholera. There's gonna be a great novel about that later. All right, got our pickles in our salad mix. We got our bagged salad items here with a baby spinach option as well as a mixed, oh, it's Italian. Gonna have to see the passport on that guy. Italians these days, hard to trust. I'm gonna throw that in there. All right, and then I'm going to put a little bit of our chopped onion in here. You didn't see me chopping? Because that's movie magic, baby. That is the secret ingredient. Put that in there. Gonna make a nasty sauce, a little bit of the mayonnaise we got here. Glob of that. Our good friend olive oil is gonna come in. She's leaving Popeye for us. So we have to give a lot of respect there. Put a little bit of the same spice mixture here in the salad to kind of reinforce the tones. We'll have a nice little zing to what we've got going on here. Give us a little bit of thickness to kind of coat everything. And essentially, this is just going to get shoved into the pita pocket along with the chicken. So, is it an appetizer? No. Is it part of the pita experience? Yes. And, all right, we've got that thoroughly mixed. So, what I'm going to do now is make a little bit of that famous white sauce. We're going to combine with a little bit of the hot sauce when we build the pita. And this is a little bit of a street meat callback because that's what we do here is we're making some nasty foods for nasty people because it's all we've got. So we've got some mayonnaise in there. A little bit of lime juice. I'm gonna put in some oregano. And maybe a little bit more oregano than I expected. A little bit of olive oil. And some of this Cajun seasoning here. I'm gonna give this a little bit of heat on its own. Be nice. Rip this together with a fork.
Said no one ever.
A dash more. A dash of mayonnaise. Nice. Thicken it up into that nice white sauce. It's going to commingle so well with that hot sauce when you put it into the pita pocket. Salad container here. Now, you know, I think our bread starter has got enough of foam on here. You can see to allow us to start making that. What we're gonna do is throw this bad boy into a mixing bowl. Make sure we get it. So back into our bread here. Our starter is just starting to start. And I'm going to add one egg into this bad boy before I put in my flour and a little bit more sugar and oil. And the spice that we have that I think is going to play the nicest with this bread is everything bagel. Make some everything bagel bread. I think everyone's gonna love it, because who doesn't love an everything bagel? It's everything. Now, the important thing about this bread is we want to make sure we're really getting the right consistency in the dough, and that's gonna mean a lot of hand beating. All right, so we need to get our flour and a little bit of baking soda. It's gonna help this bad boy rise to the occasion. All right, that's about the right amount of baking soda. Just a little zhuzh. I don't really personally feel the need to put. I like what baking soda does. I do not like the taste of baking soda. I think over baking powdered or soded bread is incorrigible. So, here in the apocalypse, we do not have a mixer. So, it's important to underflour it first, and then we're going to get this to a consistency with our little BB whisk here. That will start to firm up. Of course, you know, in the meantime, our chicken is marinating, so want to kind of give that a little shake and a little bit of rub. Get those flavors distributed. You can see here, everything is kind of working itself around. Starting to coagulate a bit. We're certainly going to need more flour now, but I want to make sure that everything we've got in here is just kind of well mixed. Thin bagel seasoning, make a nice bready combo. Are you ready for this? Do, 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 do. Probably. Long proteins to make friends with all of its friends. Alright. Should be the right amount of flour. Dough or do not. There is no try. I think Yoda said that. I'm pretty sure. As you can see, we're starting to get a little bit more cohesive. I kind of want this to be a bit of a thick bread. Not looking for anything too holy or holier than thou. Who's going to start the first church in the apocalypse, right? I wonder. It's gonna be cool. Very excited. Post quarantine. We're still pre-boogaloo here.
So just gonna beat this until my bango wangs give up.
Okay. All right, so the doomsday clocktail hour, we have the toilet paper airplane. For our sort of appetizer here, the Cajun salad salad. And then we have the everything bagel is broken, giant muffin thing. And we are kind of finishing out with our Pete Apocalypse. And then our dessert, all hope. We've got some old kind of sweet bread.
A little bit over there. Got a nice cooling effect to it. And then put in a little bit of our hot sauce. And that is how you do a Pete Apocalypse. Let's give this a try and burn my face.
This really braced me for the death of society. I'm ready. How about you? This has given me everything I need to know. So good. The crunch, Assyrian spices really kind of play in here very well. I added in a little bit of harissa, get a little bit of a North African hot spice flavor here. You know, I honestly think you could use a little bit more of this nasty-ass mayonnaise mix that I made. And let's give it another bite for posterity. This is a Pete Apocalypse I can get behind. Well, I won't make you suffer through our dessert all hope portion of eating, but thank you for joining us on the first episode of Quarantine Contessa. And we hope to see you tomorrow, where we're gonna make another nasty ass dish out of our food that we have. We're not buying any more food, not buying any more booze. It's gonna get weirder and weirder as the rations get shorter and shorter. Thanks for stopping by. Can't throw anything out during the apocalypse. Eat it, don't eat it.